So, hello. Today we're going to do a little tryout project for a quadratic diffuser made of styrofoam. I've heard that it can be pretty good. So, I'm going to take you along on this journey. I'm going to put up some schematics and some math behind it, or at least the website that I took the math from, and we're just gonna build this thing and see what happens. Quadratic diffusers are mainly made up of wells, and the depth kind of determines how well it does. When you put in the measurements on this website, I'm gonna put it up somewhere around here. You can pick the size, overall width of your diffuser and the amount of wells. And the more wells, the higher up in frequency it goes. The depth usually determines how low it goes. And I'm gonna have 23 wells in this one, which means that I'm gonna have to do a lot of cutting. The table of depths is on the screen right now. As you can see, there are a lot of different cuts and some that are not cuts at all. So I'm gonna quickly convert these to... So I calculated all the different wells, and these are the different heights. I simply wrote 1 to 18, but there were numbers missing, so should have seen that coming. So here we have the original depth of the well, and the deepest well is 19.6, so there is zero when you're working the other way up. So those will both will be completely empty. I'm basically gonna start cutting the bigger ones first. I need two of each apart from this specific length. For contrast, these things will be half a meter high. So this is 1 meter by 50 centimeters. And I'm gonna cut it this way and then glue them together. And the effective range of this thing will gonna be 488 hertz up to 5200 hertz. I don't know the specific number, but it's gonna be a pretty half decent diffuser panel. And I am going to need probably two of these right next together behind my speaker setup. So let's start cutting. Quick note, I was not gonna glue this all together in one piece. I was gonna have a backing board, and it's also gonna function as a cutting board, since it probably will do that rather nicely. We'll have to find a ruler that's 50 centimeters long that is gonna make it so that I can cut straight and measure everything I want. As a knife, I got this knife. It's relatively thin, and if that doesn't work, I have this knife. This thing is absolutely paper thin. It's about 1 or 1.1 mil in thickness, so hopefully that will work. I'm gonna do the smallest cut, the 2.2 centimeters, as a practice cut and see what happens. See you on the other side. So I just made my first cut. It's not perfectly angular, but close enough for a tryout cut. This stuff is harder to cut than I thought with a knife. I am gonna try and loop this thing a bit with something. I don't know what yet. Probably not the smartest idea, given that I want to glue this stuff. And cleaning it is probably not easy either. You do have to take a few attempts at cutting it. I did this one in 3 times and I'd probably use more. I'm gonna try the different knife now, see what happens. So I cut all of them. So there at the bottom we have the 18.5s, and then we go up. Then here we have the 2.2 centimeter ones. Then obviously there is also going to be a blank space in this entire thing. Now I have to get this board up to size. I don't know how yet, but we'll figure it out. So, short bit on cutting. As you can see, I have the other knife here. Get yourself one of the longest knives you have. That helps, because you want to have a really not that steep of angle of getting in this stuff. The other knife, let me get it. Here is, I don't know, it just cuts less. Maybe it's the dimples on this thing. Well, when you cut vegetables with it, it usually helps with it not sticking, but it certainly doesn't help with this stuff. Long, fast cuts, not too deep. I go into it about, go through it in about 3 slices, and as you can see, the corners can get pretty smooth. When you cut with some force. So, workshop, as you can see, it's absolutely stacked. Pallets everywhere, firewood for the winter. Anyhow, I am gonna risk my fingers with the table saw. Why? Because I have a second plate that I'm not gonna use immediately, so why not? Let's cut this thing and see and try and figure out if this thing will focus. This dimension needs to be cut off. Like that one, I'm not that scared of. I can do on the table saw, and this one probably focus damn thing. It's gonna be a handsaw type of deal. I'm pretty handy with a handsaw. That sticker is gonna be on there. So I cut this thing to size. As you can see, it's much smaller. I ended up cutting this with a handsaw, and this line was the table saw, which basically became a freehand table saw job, because the guide rail is extremely crooked, so I'm gonna have to fix that someday. But still, it's fine enough. It's 50 centimeters high, a little bit more, but that should be fine. It's not a big deal. So I'm gonna start laying out the foam pieces in the order which is presented on the website. I am gonna test the glue on this stuff first. This is a little extra cut I have, because I think that stuff's pretty thick, and you cannot put that much force on this. Well, you can, but you're gonna dent it, so you need to probably wiggle it in place a bit. And let's see, this is the correct size. As you can see, no real overhang of either product. It's a bit over there, but it's fine. It should be fine. So what we have here is the basic layout of the thing. I started out without any numbers and just this list and the little table, but since the table on the website shows you this value and I cut everything at this value, which means I need to convert everything, and I made a lot of mistakes. Also, I cut one too little of this one, which meant I had to cut another one, and also I forgot the S0, which was 19.6. So I basically put the entire table with the converted values. I wrote them down again. Then I numbered the entire plate because I lost track of where I was every single freaking time. But this is the basic diffuser. I don't know how good you can see it. I can't see the screen right now, so it's probably good. Now I need to start gluing this thing up and looking at the time, if the thing will focus. It's 9, so I have about 1.5 hours before I need to really get to bed. So I hope I can get this thing finished, all glued up. But it's starting to take shape. So I'm done up to this point. And this glue works absolute magic. This is one of the highest ones, and this is just glued pretty much at the bottom. The stuff doesn't weigh anything, so that probably helps with strength. And 8 is gonna be a free space, so then I'm gonna put this entire block from 9 up to 14, then 15 is also gonna be a blank space, and then all this other stuff is gonna get glued up next to that. And then we should be good. Yeah, loving this project, loving the glue. Don't know if you can see that, but you don't use that much of it, to be honest. So you should be able to do one or two panels. At least one, probably maybe two if you're a bit more scarce with glue, but I'm not. So this entire panel, that stuff is about 15. I was, for the entirety, for the two plates and the styrofoam, I was about 30 something euros. So if this works, it's a great addition to your audio room, since it's, well, audio wise it's pretty much free. Even getting barely decent cabling, for example, some Audio Quest cables cost more than this, and this will do so much more for your sound if this stuff doesn't resonate. But if I listen to that, it's not much more than when I tap the table, so that shouldn't resonate too much, hopefully. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm gonna do, but the thing looks half decent, so just gonna continue, finish it, let it dry up a bit, and then just probably hang it. I don't know how, but I'm gonna, maybe I just put it in the right up to the glass of my window, right behind, right in the center. Put the curtains in front of it, so that should take a bit of the resonance away. But I'm gonna finish gluing this up, and then I'll take you to the listening room, set it up. So here we are back again. It's all glued up. Basically, the gluing tactic that I used was lay a strip down the bottom, and then like a strip right between here, right, probably as high up as possible. I glued it, even these ones. And right now you can see that they're not cut perfectly, and that they're, some are at a bit of an angle, and I could probably send that down in the future, but I'm gonna test it. Like here we have this massive gap and all that, but When you look at it from the front, it looks, it doesn't look half bad. So, gonna listen to some music for, I don't know, 30 minutes, come back, because this part is already pretty much solid as a rock. And then I am going to listen to this thing. Okay, welcome to my seating position. Right here we have the diffusor. As you can see, my old setup was that blanket across those two old open bevel failed GR Research replicas. Mostly my fault. And I always had the curtains closed. That is a very thick cotton wool blanket. My testing track of today is Talking Prairie Boy. Sounds really open, and he sounds right at the back of the soundstage, which for me is pretty much right up against the window, which is not preferable, because my soundstage is about that square right here, across here from the speakers. So I wanted to be a bit further away, and I want to see if that thing will offer some luck. I'm gonna turn those cabinets around and see what that does for the sound, so they don't have this big reflective surfaces without that blanket on. See what happens. So here we go. I'm not gonna, who cares? My video get demonetized. I'm not making money on this anyhow.
Talking Prairie Boy. Back on the booze, he's swinging a driver at a big bull moose, keeps getting on the goddamn property, or so he says. Cigarettes are expensive and whiskey ain't cheap, and winters are bitter, but the summers are...
First note, the guitar and Coulter sound in the same spot now. The old setup, the guitar was always somewhat left of him, and now it's right with him, and it doesn't sound as far away anymore, which is interesting. So I'm gonna listen to a few more tracks, and then I'm gonna experiment with the curtains in front of it, and also I'm trying to get that blanket back in front of it, because that is always preferred over just the curtains and the window. So maybe now with the diffuser behind it, it is even better, but just have to check. See you in a bit. The soundstage depth about pretty much, I doubled it, which I'm happy with, because now instead of the, what is it, two and a half meters, about 2 meters from the wall to my the front of my speaker, I now have about 4 meters of soundstage depth, and it sounds a bit more realistic. It's not as wide as it was before, but it's deeper, so it gives the illusion that everything's bigger. I do have an old problem again, which is that instruments are a bit further back, but luckily singer is more in front now. It's not everything is right there at the back. Guitars and bass and trumpets and all that kind of stuff sounds about at the rear wall, and then when there's a drum kit behind that, it actually sounds behind it still. So it goes a bit past the wall now, which is an absolute blessing. Project good. Awesome, I like it. I'm gonna build the second one and I'm gonna experiment with that. You will see that. If you like these types of videos, maybe even subscribe. I am going to try and do some of these things in the future. I do have other products, other projects. As you can see, I have the big open baffle ones. I have these DIY speakers with the Mark audio drivers. I have those giant damping panels. I can make a video about those because those really helped big time. Always counter first reflections. Next up might be the wall of the floor. I might do something with that. That's the base cable for some of my interconnects. I use the cable that thing I can also review, but I do need new output tubes for that. They are absolutely cooked. I have a lot to say about that thing. In Europe, fat, shipping, everything included, €380. Throw in $80 worth, €80 or 40, 50, 60, 70 euros of tubes, and some other things in there that really take that thing to another level. And it's better than my Meridian amplifier. I can also do things about the DAC. As you can see, I have also some pretty funky cables in there. There's also a power cable in the back there. That's the same geometry. My interconnects are with that style. I am willing to make video about that, but growing a channel on cable videos is not the best idea on YouTube. So before you say cables don't matter, just use lamp cord or the stuff in the wall makes more of a difference. Actually, those cables are made out of the stuff that is inside your wall. It's not OCC, copper, silver, whatever the hell. It's just copper wiring in a funny shape. So I will do a review about that. Like, comment, subscribe, the whole shebang, and see you in another video.